down talking, please. Mike, elected Charlotte, introductions. My name's Marvin Phillips. I'm president, parliamentarian, land use, public safety chair, legislative analyst for the Alliance for Better District 6. I also live on the 12th floor of this building. Michael?
Hi, my name is Michael Nolte, and I serve as the executive director of the Alliance for Better District 6, and I'll be chairing the meeting. And hopefully everybody, there are going to be times during the meeting, might want to take pictures, because it'll be one of our fun meetings. All right, do introductions. Introduce yourself.
My name's Alana Lipset with Tidewater Capital.
I'm Reginald Meadows. I live here in the building on the 11th floor. I'm also a member of this board here, and also on the 21 People's Congress and others. Yes.
My name is Lauren Small. I'm with Glide.
Oh, my name is Dave Anderson, and I'm with the Cadillac Hotel, the concert series, monthly concert series that the Cadillac has, free concert every month.
Thank you. My name is Susan Bryan. I'm resident and treasurer of Alliance for Better District 6. I live in the neighborhood.
Dory, I'm producer of 6 shows for Public Access 2, which I host live, and the other 4 are pre-recorded, and this may end up on my show. Also, I live next door at the Ritz Hotel. I'm president of the Central City.
Vice president. You're vice president of this organization.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, this one, but the other one.
George?
I'm George Dias. I'm the business chair. I'm also an insurance agent. I have Next Step Insurance Solutions in the neighborhood here. I'm a 22-year Tenderloin resident. I live in the Hamilton condos on O'Farrell Street.
My name is Donnell
Bull, and
I'm with the hospitality.
Cool.
My name is Steve.
My name is John Hamdahl. I'm with J.S. Sullivan.
My name is Riyad Ghanem. I'm with J.S. Sullivan, too.
My name is Eve Langston Bartow. I'm with the Eastern District and a board member of the Alliance for District 6.
My name is Peter Stevens. I'm also with the Eastern District and
Paul Garantian, I'm with the Alliance Foundation.
Hey, I'm Terry Morris, and I work for the San Francisco AIDS Foundation.
Could you speak up?
Foundation, I'm also the 24-hour
chief. Is that everybody?
Robert? Okay.
I'm Fernando Pujols. I work with the Tenderloin Community Benefit District, and I'm here to talk about the Taylor Street project.
Dennis Eisner, Administrative Officer for the Alliance.
Thank you. Our ground rules are on the back of your agenda. We ask that you turn off all pagers, cell phones, and electronic devices, as we are videotaping our meeting. We also ask that you do not want to be on the videotape, just stay behind the camera. No hackling or name calling, please. We also want you to create a safe environment which every participant feels that they are free to speak by reserving any negativity. We want you to speak responsibly and emphasize the positive. Please do not interrupt another speaker or engage in side conversations or other distracting behavior when others are speaking. Since nobody's campaigning. We also have a pet policy with no pets. I see no pets here, but I'm not sure about it. Are there any questions on the ground rules?
Actually, we want to do something before that. I want to do a roll call of the board members, see which ones are here and which aren't here. So Marvis Phillips is here, Michael Nolte is here, Denise Dory is here, she's our vice president. Dennis Eisner is here, our administrative officer. Susan Bryan, our treasurer, is here. He's here, board member. And Joe Baldino is absent. George Diaz is here, and Reggie's here. Amos is absent at this point. Okay. We have four. That should have been part of the introduction, but that's a new procedure we're doing because we want to make sure our board members attend our meetings. So can we have an adoption of our agenda? Is there any additions to it? I understand somebody had an announcement to add to the, any, raise your hands if anybody has announcements. I know you had one. Anybody else?
Sorry, I just want to clarify that an announcement is not something that's separate that's added to the agenda. So if you want to add something to the agenda, then that's fine. But if it's just an announcement, that's under the announcement that's already on the agenda.
Okay.
So yeah, so unless there are any changes or additions, I motion then to approve the agenda.
Is there a second? All those in favor say aye.
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 Any no's, any abstentions? Motion carries. Membership committee report. Our organization is run, this is where George gets up. Our organization is run on membership dues and also donations. That's the only two ways our organization is operates. And so I'll go in a few minutes to pass around membership forms to people that are new to the meeting. And donations, we will be having door prizes and food at this event. And there's a lot of things we do that have the cost money for our, everything comes out of our the money we make, goes right back into the meetings and stuff that we do, or the other activities we do, just operate. So George is our fundraising chair. So now we move on to our item five, which is the SFMTA Safer Taylor Street project. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Our projector's up. We're getting there.
Okay, well, we'll talk about something else. Person, Nancy Pelosi. That's why I wanted somebody from
equalization. And the point of this is that we believe in public recognition of people when we do give out awards, because not terribly times our people are going to be recognized, and when they are, we want them to be properly recognized, and we saw you as an unsung hero for the Temple One, as well as all the other people who are recognized that we listen to. And we wanted to make sure we properly recognized, and so we're and so we hope that you see more of you.
We're
go to item 10 on the agenda, while they figure out, or are you,
you go.
It's not that quick. Okay, they're figuring out what needs to be done, and then maybe if that doesn't work, let's see if your computer works.
Sorry.
Okay, go ahead. Item 10 is where we're jumping to right now, while we deal with the...
several projects receiving environmental review. I have a public safety plan, but my lieutenant is here or not to receive her award.
Just get to the public report.
Okay.
On 793 South Van Ness is doing an environmental review for a project that will consist of 85,000 square foot building. The 2 3-bedroom units, 28 2-bedroom units, 39 1-bedroom units. And there's an alternative plan that calls for a slightly smaller building with 29 2-bedroom units, 37 1-bedroom units, and 3 studios. And it's located at South Van Ness and Mitchell. Excuse me. South Van Ness and 19th Street. I also have a project receiving environmental review for 973 Mission Street, which is called the Proud School. It's a nonprofit private school. And it's they'll be building a space that's prepared 2,300 square feet. Will consist of classrooms, offices, small meeting rooms, and assembly space for the community. There will be no food preparation on the site. They will serve lunch. And they will have breakout areas for individual student work and other activities. The school will be holding approximately 120 students. And they will be on Mission Street and Minna Street between 5th and 6th Street. But I also have a project receiving environmental review, 1990 Folsom Street. It's a project site bounded by 16th, Folsom, and Shawwell in the Mission District. It's a planned mixed-use building with 143 units, 156,230 square feet. It'll have 10,000 square feet of production, distribution, and repair uses, including a 3,000 square foot mezzanine, 5,000 square feet of child care facility, and an open space patio on Shawwell. We're also have two buildings, one a seven-story building, one a three-story building. Seven-story building will consist of 23 studios, 47 one-bedrooms, 53 two-bedrooms, and 4 three-bedrooms. And a smaller building will consist of 6 three-bedroom units. And I have a letter of determination for 2070 Bryant Street, which is a large project authorization for housing with the Mayor's Office of Housing, and it was approved. I also have a letter of determination for 700 Valencia, which is a restaurant and with a cocktail lounge on the ground floor, a entertainment venue with alcohol in the basement. That was approved. I also have a letter for 12 Mint Street, which was for office use. That letter was approved. I also have a letter for 470 Alabama Street, which is a business known as the Archery. It is a San Francisco-based in-residence program giving people with everyday space to work